Hello, and welcome to FedRAMP's walkthrough of the Open Security Controls Assessment Language, otherwise known as OSCAL. The purpose of this video is to provide an overview of the resources, guidance, and templates available in OSCAL. First, we'll review OSCAL and why we're using it. Next, we'll review the data repositories available from NIST and FedRAMP, which are located on GitHub. Last, we'll provide a look inside FedRAMP's guidebook and the SSP template. In an effort to increase authorization speed and implement process efficiencies that will boost agency acceptance and reciprocity of FedRAMP authorizations, FedRAMP partnered with NIST to develop OSCAL. Security artifacts and deliverables can be developed using OSCAL, which in turn can be read by machines. This sets the foundation for future automation efforts to include future tool creation to support the development and review of authorization packages. Let me show you the various resources that exist and where you can find them. NIST publishes their resources on their GitHub repository. Here you can find general OSCAL knowledge, which we encourage you to explore prior to working with OSCAL. Resources that will help you understand how to apply OSCAL to FedRAMP can also be found on GitHub. Let's dive into the FedRAMP repository now and show you around. We recommend starting with the FedRAMP Registry. To access the registry, you'll first navigate to the Documents section. Here you'll find the registry in Excel format. Just click to download it. When NIST began developing OSCAL, it was important to ensure the language would be useful across cybersecurity frameworks. As a result, NIST enabled OSCAL to be extended for unique needs. The FedRAMP Registry is the authoritative source of FedRAMP's extensions to OSCAL and includes FedRAMP-specific fields called extensions, as well as identifiers, and accepted values. As you can see, the registry is specific to the System Security Plan, or SSP. As FedRAMP adopts OSCAL to other authorization package deliverables, we will update the registry to reflect the SAP, SAR, and POAM OSCAL extensions. After getting a better understanding of the FedRAMP registry, you'll want to dive into the Guide to OSCAL-based FedRAMP System Security Plans. To access the guide, you will again navigate to the FedRAMP GitHub repository and click on the Documents link. Here, you can view or download the guide, which provides everything you'll need to create tools that can read, write, and manipulate FedRAMP-compliant OSCAL files. Chapters 1 and 2 provide important foundational concepts which are necessary for understanding the rest of this guide. Chapter 3 discusses the FedRAMP extensions, identifiers, and accepted values we saw in the registry. Chapters 4, 5, and 6 are the heart of this guide. For each page in the Microsoft Word-based FedRAMP SSP template, these chapters show you how to represent the content in FedRAMP-compliant OSCAL. The guidebook appendices address important yet more advanced concepts. As FedRAMP applies OSCAL to the rest of the authorization package, additional guides will appear in the FedRAMP GitHub repository. Now let's take a look at the SSP template in OSCAL. To access the template, you will again navigate to the FedRAMP GitHub Automation Repository. This time, click on the Templates section. Here you will find the choice of viewing the SSP template in JSON or XML. Let's look at the XML template. OSCAL files are intended to be read, written, and manipulated by tools, not humans. FedRAMP provides these templates as both an example to tool developers and a starting point for tool users. Most concepts described in the guide are represented in the template. This allows tool developers to see how a minimally complete file should look. They can also use the template to check the correct function of their tools. For tool users, the templates are preloaded with some FedRAMP content, such as information about the JAB and placeholders for information required by FedRAMP. The templates also include example content to better illustrate some of the topics covered by the guide. As FedRAMP applies OSCAL to the rest of the authorization package, and as we receive feedback from stakeholders, updated materials and additional templates will appear in our repository. We thank you for watching this video and encourage you to send your questions and comments to info@fedramp.gov with the subject line OSCAL Video Question. As you familiarize yourself with the OSCAL language using the NIST and FedRAMP resources, we encourage you to begin developing the necessary tools to read and write SSPs and other authorization deliverables in OSCAL. We are confident that a faster route to authorization is near with the use of OSCAL. A special thank you to NIST for their leadership in the development of OSCAL. Additionally, thank you to DigitalGov University for the production and hosting of this video.